Hey, what is it, guys? Welcome to AXT. And the last video that I made was about bitcoins. So if you don't know what bitcoin is, then go ahead and check that out. What is bitcoin and how does it work? I'll leave the link in the description or in a card. I wasn't much in details in the last video. So in this video, I'm going to explain it in full details. How does it work and how to mine any cryptocurrency. Yes, internet currency is called cryptocurrency. So currently there are 7 cryptocurrency in my knowledge. First up is the Bitcoin, which we already know. Then Litecoin, Ethereum, Zcash, Dash, Ripple and Monero. These cryptocurrencies has different values and different ways to mine. Well, I cannot cover all of them, but I'm going to cover the Bitcoin. Don't worry, I promise I'm going to cover it in other videos. So, as I said, for mining, you need a powerful PC and GPU, of course. In bank, or you might say PayPal. Okay, in PayPal, if you send money, they keep a track how much money I have in my account. And they won't let me send more money than I have in my account. And also will let the other know that I have sent them the money. So PayPal keeps this database of transactions. To be more significant, it is called a ledger. So PayPal as a company has one ledger and it is only held by themselves. But in Bitcoin network, that ledger is distributed to every participant, anybody who connects the Bitcoin network. It has a full transaction history of the network since the day it was made in 2009. So now you might think, who keeps the track of those transactions? Like in PayPal, as a company, they have one ledger and they themselves put the information in the ledger. Well, Bitcoin is no centralized authority. So that's this role goes to the miners. Miners check the electronic signature which is validly signed in the network and create a block of those informations and add to the Bitcoin network ledger. Actually, that ledger in Bitcoin is called blockchain. They add the block to the blockchain and that new block is mathematically linked to the blocks which was created in past. And it gets distributed to all the participants in the network. So what the miner did is a public good. He did a great job. I mean, he should be getting a reward. So he gets a reward by the network. And that reward is to stick in that ledger for 10 minutes and make a special transaction. And in that transaction, the miner can pay himself 12.5 bitcoins, which comes from nowhere. That is the only transaction where it doesn't has any inputs, no inputs at all, which literally can be said money created out of thin air. And that is how new Bitcoin comes in the market. And this activity for doing public good is now called mining or crypto mining. It's like digging side of a mountain and getting gold. So that's the explanation what crypto mining is actually. Now, let's concentrate how to mine it actually. Well, I'm talking about only Bitcoin mining. I'm not going to cover all the other cryptocurrencies. There are two ways of mining any cryptocurrency. Number one, mining it all by yourself, that is solo mining. Number two, mining it by joining a pool, pool mining. Since the competitions are so high, it's really hard to get a block in solo mining. You might get one block in a year or so, only if you have a system which is very powerful. So, NiceHash is one of the best miner. Well, you'll need your Bitcoin wallet though. You can use the Coinbase, which is good for US or UK locations. Coinbase doesn't actually work in India. So, you can use the ZPay for India. I'll leave the links in the description for both the wallets and the NiceHash miner. You can go ahead and download it. Once you download the NiceHash miner, install the application. Once you've done that, open it up. So now you need to set it up. You need to put the wallet address and then your worker name, and you need to select which GPU or processor are you going to use. So go ahead and fill all of them up. Once you've done that, click on the start and it will start mining. Well, the earning depends on the mining rate. The power of these GPUs is calculated by hashes. My GPU is pretty on the low end and the mining rate is actually 150 mega hashes per second, which gives me around $0.6 per day and monthly around $18, or in Indian rupees it's 1100. It actually depends on how powerful your GPU is. Well, currently Nvidia 1080 Ti makes around $87 to $100 per month. Yes, it is expensive. Graphic cards are expensive. If you're thinking on spending money on the expensive card, you better get an ASIC, which gives a better mining hash rate and more earning, of course. But in ASIC, you don't have the flexibility to mine all the cryptocurrencies. But in a GPU, you can mine all of them. ASICs are made only for specific currency. I mean, for a specific algorithm. And also, this earnings always fluctuates as the Bitcoin value fluctuates. You'll have to run the GPU 24x7 for earning. Might be continuously for a month. Don't worry, your GPU will not burn up. But definitely, it lowers the life of the GPU though. That's it for the solo mining. So now let's see how to do a pool mining. Pool mining actually works when a lot of miner combines and work together for one goal. It's actually a lot faster than mining solo. The miners get reward proportionate to the works they provide. So mining a Bitcoin with a pool, I suggest the slush pool. Slush pool has mining rate of 800 petahashes per second. Oh, that's insane. It works real great. First up, you need to sign up to the slush pool. I'll leave the link of the slush pool in the description so that you can go ahead and check that out. With the slush pool, you can mine Bitcoin and Zcash too. And again, I'm only going to show the Bitcoin mining, not the Zcash. Once you're done signing up, it will bring you to the dashboard. And you need to set up little things like adding your wallet, worker name. So go ahead and click on the settings. And then on the left, we get the Bitcoin. And after that, click on the payouts. And then you'll get to put your wallet address. So put your wallet address and click on submit. Also, you need to verify the link that they send on your email address that you provided. Once it's done adding your wallet, go ahead and click on the worker. Add a new worker, give any name you like. And your mining login ID will be your username dot your worker name. So in my case, my miner ID is nofantasyguy.1050ti. Okay, right after that, you need to download a software. GUI Miner. I'll leave the links in the description. So, download it, install it, and then open it up. Close the default tab. Click on the file, new miner, click new OpenCL miner. Then give it a name, and then select the server as others. So, host. Now, I wanted to get back to the slush pool site. And click on the worker tab, and then click how to start mining. And then you'll get the server location and addresses. Since I'm from Asia, I need to copy the Asia address and paste it on the host in the GUI miner, and the port will be 3333, as you can see right here. After that, enter your miner ID and password. Select the device you want to use and number of cores you want to use, and then click start mining, and it will start mining. So in the slush pool site, in the dashboard, you can check your hash rates and your earnings, and you can put as many workers you want. So that's it for the crypto mining. And if you think this video helped you, then don't forget to smash that like button, share it with your friends, and also subscribe to my channel. So see you guys in the next one.